Hello, ungoogleable. Welcome to your life. Today is beautiful. Please log in.
At the end of junior year of high school, Jenna met Ethan. We were drunk. We hooked up, she said. We saw each other again, drunk at another party, so we hooked up again. Then we met at after prom and hooked up cause we had hooked up before, and so it was comfortable and whatever. And so began their non-romance. In fact, Jenna made it clear to Ethan that she didn't want a Facebook relationship. There are people who have Facebook relationships, where every day it tests like a pickle status update, delivered in a sing-song out to lunch with babe. Kissy picture of this, kissy picture of that. 2 weeks later, they re-broken up. And then a test bitchy voice doing the status update certain people need to, like, stop stalking me on Facebook. Clearly we are never getting back together. There's the tailless whips and then there's the people who are just long-haired don'ty care. They just don'ty give a single fuck. They read just like, I'm gonna have sex with you. I am gonna have sex with you. Hey, you retweet. I am gonna have sex with you too if I want to. They don'ty give a shit. That, she told Ethan, was how it was going to be. I told him it was just hooking up. I was so used to guys treating me like shit, I didn't want any guy to take advantage of me. And Ethan took her words to heart. He said, okay, he wanted to hook up with other girls. And I was like, sure, if you don't want to be in a relationship with me, I don't really care. So I was like, fine, I'll start hooking up with other guys. So I would come to his house, no nonsense, clothes off, let us do this, get into my bed. And we would hook up every couple days. It started being a casual thing. This went on for about a year. We were friends with benefits, Jenna said. Sometimes we wouldn't even talk that much. I'd just be like, I am coming over, and then I'd go over and we'd sleep together, and then I'd leave. Even when Ethan, drunk at another party, admitted to Jenna that I think of you as my girlfriend, she told him, I would never, ever in my fucking life be your girlfriend. Immediately his face fell, and he walked away, and after that we were pretty mean to each other. They still continued hooking up. And then, last spring, Jenna's grandfather died, and Jenna was furious with Ethan when he didn't reach out to console her. I finally texted him like, my grandfather died, and you have nothing to say to me? And I've been sleeping with you for a year. And his response was, so I really just don't see why you said I could never be your boyfriend. She smiled. So we realized we were being super stupid, and I was like, do you want to be in a relationship? What do you want? And he was like, I really love you. I've never met anybody like you. You're not a dumb bitch. So now we're together. 2 weeks later, they're broken up. And then a test bitchy voice doing the status update certain people need to, like, stop stalking me on Facebook. Clearly we are never getting back together. There's the tailless whips and then there's the people who are just long-haired don'ty care. They just don'ty give a single fuck. They read just like, I am gonna have sex with you. I am gonna have sex with you. Hey, you retweet. I am gonna have sex with you too if I want to. They don'ty give a shit. That, she told Ethan, was how it was going to be. I told him it was just hooking up. I was so used to guys treating me like shit, I didn't want any guy to take advantage of me. And Ethan took her words to heart. He said, okay, he wanted to hook up with other girls. And I was like, sure, if you don't want to be in a relationship with me, I don't really care. So I was like, fine, I'll start hooking up with other guys. So I would come to his house, no nonsense, clothes off, let us do this, get into my bed.
Yeah.
Thank you for logging out. Today was a wonderful day. Please come back tomorrow.
Red. Blue. Green.
Mic check 1, 2.
Congratulations. You reject the good enough. You reject words like symbolism and postmodernism. Obsolescence is not part of your vocabulary. Every night, every day, every step of the way. The diktat of fashion. The agenda of the color wheel. Gone. It takes more than a pretty face to catch your attention. I repeat. It takes more than a pretty face to catch your attention. Good. That is very good. We are source decoded. For you. For the most perfect moisturizer. The most advanced cosmetic lineup. Scientifically proven, scientifically tested. For you.
Congratulations, calibration completed.